Hello students, good morning to all. So today we will continue lesson 3, Microsoft advanced features of Excel. So in the last class we have studied about the different types of charts in Excel and how to create a chart in Excel with the help of the entered data in the spreadsheet. Now today we will study how to sort the data on the spreadsheet. So now see how to sort in Excel. So first of all, we have to highlight the rows and columns which you want to sort, and after that we navigate to data along the top and select sort. If sorting by column or select the column, if you want to sort by column, so select the column you want to order your sheet by. If you want to sort by a row, click options and select the sort left to right. Choose what would you like sorted. Choose how would you like to order your sheet, and after that you click on OK. Now see, first you highlight the rows or columns which you want to sort. To sort a range of cells in Excel, first click and drag your cursor across your spreadsheet to highlight all of the cells you want to sort, even those rows and columns whose value you are not actually sorting. For example, you can see here, if you want to sort column A, see here, if you want to sort column A, so select this entire column, means highlight this column A. Okay, so if you want to sort column A, but there is data associated with column A in columns B and C, so it is important to highlight all the three columns to ensure that the values in column B and C move along with the cells you are sorting in column A. So here the data associated with the column A is the column B and C also, so highlight the three columns. Okay, then you can go for the sorting. Okay, so let me open that Microsoft Excel, and there I will show you how to apply the sorting. So under the data tab, you will find this sort button A to Z. Once all the data you want to sort is highlighted, select the data tab. Which tab? Select the data tab along the top navigation bar. This tab will expand a new set of options beneath it where you can select the sort button. The icon has an A to Z graphic on it, you can see, but you will be able to sort in more ways than just alphabetically. Next is sorting by column. Select the column you want to order and your sheet by. So when you hit the sort button shown above, a window of settings will appear. This is where you can configure what you would like sorted and how you would like to sort it. So here it will ask the column sort by last name, sort by first name or house, like this. So let me open. Let me open Excel. Yes. So this is the window of the Microsoft Excel 2010. Now let me open any saved file. So I have book 1, lesson 2, part 4. So let me open this book 1, lesson 2, part 4. Now let me delete all these things. Now here, I want to do the sorting of this marks. So in which order, who got the highest mark in the written according to that format. So suppose I am selected these three columns here. I selected the three columns, name, oral and written. And see, these three columns are highlighted. So after that, I have to go on the data tab. Now see, in the data tab, we'll find the sort button. Okay. Now on the sort button, see, sort by, here the column name is asking. by which column? Three column I selected, name, oral and written. So I want to sort by written. Okay, written column. So sort on values. Here values or cell color or fill color. So sort on values, what is given there. On the basis of the color also we can do the sorting. On the basis of the font color also. Okay. Order, which order? Smallest to largest or largest to smallest? So largest to smallest. Okay. By default it is smallest to largest. Now click on OK. Now see, who got the largest marks, who got the highest marks, this name appear first, 99, 85, 85, 75, like this. So now it is sorted. This is the way how we sort the data in the Microsoft Excel. Okay. So sorting means arranging the data in the ascending order or the descending order in a worksheet. So the data can be sorted on the basis of the text, numbers, combination of text, numbers or dates, and on the other basis also. So let us apply one more time sort, and here this time on the place of the values we are going to take the font color. Order automatic, order you see automatic only on top. Okay, so there the colors are same, here the font colors are same. Okay, so you have to make some font color different, then it will work. So next, and what are the steps we have to follow to sort the data? Just we have gone through the steps. Just first of all, we have to highlight the cells, highlight the columns on which we want to apply the sorting. Okay. After that, we have to click on the data tab. Under the data tab, you will find the sort in the sort and filter group, the sort button. So when you click on the sort button, this is sort dialog box will open. There you have to select the column and the values on which you want to apply the sorting. Okay. Now next is the filter data. So how we filter the data? So many orders are there. You know, we can also sort more than one column. For example, after sorting the name, you want to arrange the list by roll number. Here again we are going to select it. That are three columns. Okay, so we can select here. See, we can also sort more than one column by sorting by name. You can here sorting by name. We can do the sorting by name also, and we can do the sorting along with the roll number also. So click on the add label button in this sort dialog box. A new label gets added below the first label. So there is the add label button. There we have to click. So see here. Just a minute. Let me again select. Yes, already it is selected. Now click on this. Sort by 99 font color. What is given? Not highlighted properly. Okay, so let me again select this three label. Let me select. Okay, selected, go on the sort. Now we find here sort by written, and here we can write the values. Okay, and here we write the largest to smallest. Okay, now add label, then by another we wants to give on the name. Okay, values no problem. A to Z it is given. A to Z let it be. Now okay. So here you find the two label sorting is applied. Okay. So the name is order in the order A to Z, and the written marks. Okay, next is the filter data. How we filter the data? Microsoft Excel provides the many ways to analyze the data in a list. So the filter features, here you find the filter in the sorting filter group, filter features. The filter feature allows you to see only those records that you want to display while it hides the rest of the data temporarily. So only the specific records it will show you on the screen, and the other records which are not satisfying the given condition, it will be hidden. So we can filter a list to display the records that meet the specific criteria by using the auto filter command also. So select the cell in the database and click on the filter button in the sort and filter group on the filter tab. So here, suppose you want to apply the filter here. So go in the filter, and here we will apply the filter. So there's the filter, you can see filter is applied. So on the name, if you want to apply the filter, how you want to apply the filter, here sort A to Z, sort Z to A, or which record you want to select. Okay, so no need to do the select all, only the I want to select the record of Anuj, Arpit, Tarsia, Chetis. Okay, this much person's record. Okay, now here in the oral marks, these are the marks written, these are the written marks. Okay, so here the number filters, so you can apply the number filters equals does not equals greater than. So any value we can pass less than, so greater than. Greater than means here, so rows which value is greater than, is greater than here, you can write the marks as 90. So whose value who got the more than 90 marks in the written. Okay, multiple conditions also you apply here, and or see. So here another condition also you can write, but here one I have written now. Okay, now see, I have got only one record. Arpit is the person who got more than 90 marks in the written. So see, other records are hidden, you cannot see. So this is the way method how to apply the filters. This is the method that we can apply the filters, as you can see here in this. Okay, so after applying the filters, we are seeing only one record. So this is all for the today, students. And so in the next class, now we have completed the how to filter the data till lesson 3, and this is in your syllabus till lesson 3 only. Lesson 1, 2, 3 is the syllabus for your first periodical test exam. So this is all for today. Thank you for your kind attention.